Hey everybody, it's Invicta, and I want to make a video really quickly covering today's balance patch for the 10th of November 2016. As always, with these newsy type videos, you can find a link down below in the YouTube information section that will take you directly to the official post from Blizzard themselves. We had a very interesting patch come through today, and this was also a little bit of a surprise with some of the changes they have made. But again, check the link down below in the information box so you can read it at your leisure, or you can feel free to pause this video as well. I'm not going to be going over everything word for word, but that is because there is a lot of stuff to get to. It's not quite as big as the PTR patch that happened last week, or technically this week, but there's still a lot to get to, so here we go. So basically, in the roundup way of things, Kel'Thas is getting a little bit of help. Don't get excited, though. He's not getting huge buff or anything like that. Vala is getting adjusted a little bit, but Sumuro, ETC, and surprisingly Malfurion are all getting nerfs, and including Zarya as well, and Muradin is also getting a little bit of help along with Murky. So the only thing they've changed for Kael'thas really is that the level 7 talent Sun King's Fury, you just get 5% extra bonus damage. I don't think anyone's really going to complain about that. Obviously, Blizzard's not going to be buffing Kael'thas anytime soon, because he, in my opinion, probably doesn't need it, but maybe some people feel differently. Let me know in the comments down below. Going on to Vala, someone who I recently just spotlighted on Solo Queue Silliness not that long ago. She is getting a little bit of a nerf here just because of her damage output with her W, also known as multi-shot, is a little bit too high. They've reduced the amount of bonus damage per hatred stack from 5% to 4%. Now, that might not seem like a huge deal, but keep in mind of how many stacks you can get of hatred while playing as Vala. So it's basically a 10% nerf if you want to think of it that way, assuming that you have max stacks and that sort of thing. And then Arsenal, which is going to be the homing rocket, or I think it's the homing rockets or the grenades. It's either one of those, but the cooldown reduction per hero hit has been reduced from 3 to 2. Again, it's too much spam from W, so Blizzard has slightly adjusted that. Blizzard says Vala is sitting in a really good spot right now, but we feel the damage output compared to the ease of use is too high on her multi-shot talents. This changes the changes to punishment and Arsenal should incentivize players into taking the higher skill versus reward talents on those tiers. Multi-shot is pretty easy to use, but I think that honestly the bigger problem with multi-shot isn't necessarily the spammage, more so than the range. I think the default range for multi-shot should get taken a look at instead of dealing with the scaling damage, because that is a pretty significant nerf to punishment. But I could be wrong. Again, I'm not a game designer, and Blizzard certainly is going to know better than I. Now, moving over here to Sumuro. Sumuro is getting hit yet again, and he's getting the Zul treatment right now. He's just too powerful, and I have a feeling this is not going to be the end of the nerfs either for Sumuro, but let's go over what they changed first, and I'll give you my overall thoughts on him. So across the board, the flat basic attack damage value has been reduced from 93 to 88. And now that is going to affect Sumuro pretty much universally on all of his abilities and talents that are scaled based off of his basic attack damage. He's still going to be able to do a lot of power, but this is certainly a bigger nerf than we've seen in the past for Sumuro here. The mirror images for his Q ability, the damage has been reduced from 30% to 25% of Sumuro's damage. Again, it's a across-the-board nerf for the damage output of Sumuro. The Illusion Master, that's going to be his heroic that he gets at level 10. The damage increase has been reduced by another 5%, so you can get only a maximum of 35%, whereas it used to be 45% total for taking Illusion Master. So they're really, really hitting the mirror image build hard. And again, that was the build that I was showing during Sumuro week, and the one that has a really, really high skill cap, but there were some issues there given the fact that the mirror images could still deal too much damage, and it was too easy for Sumuro to get away. But I'll talk about that in a moment, because the level 13 talent is Shikuchi, which is the one that basically teleports him whenever he uses his Windwalk ability. The teleport range has been reduced by about 20%, which is a massive damage, or a massive distance decrease on this nerf. So here's what Blizzard says, and again, I'll give you my overall thoughts after that. Blizzard says, while there are a lot of knobs for us to turn in order to help bring Sumuro's win rate in more in line, we felt that his damage output, especially burst, was where we wanted to start first. We are happy with his survivability options and feel his fantasy should cater towards being elusive. We also realize the damage and confusion are really all he brings to a team, so we wanted to be careful with the changes. We feel that these small tweaks to his damage and the fact that they compound on each other, which is something I talked about at the very beginning, will cause a reasonable drop in his win rate and will continue to closely monitor him. So pretty much plainly spoken there by Blizzard, they want to make sure It's I know it's easy to look at this and say, well, Blizzard just wants Sumeru just to lose more, which I guess technically in a roundabout way you could kind of take that. You can sort of derive that conclusion from what they've just stated about that. I don't think that's the proper choice of wording, though, because Sumeru's win rate at almost across all levels is pretty ridiculous. Now, I don't profess to go to websites that have like log trackers for like win rates, and they should be taken with a grain of salt unless they're actually given, you know, some official verification by Blizzard of being closer to what they see, because obviously Blizzard can see everything. But I think that everyone is probably universally in agreement that Sumeru is still too powerful, not necessarily because he does a lot of damage, but it more has to do with the fact of his cleansing ability for himself. So for those of you who don't know, Sumeru basically can shed any and all crowd controlling effects as long as he has Windwalk up. And Shikuchi was an issue because he can just basically get away. It was basically the best thing. It was the best of both worlds. It was Zeratul who could also self-cleanse himself, which is insane. Especially given the fact that we saw the changes to the stealth coming soon, which is going to be instead of you knock someone out of stealth, they just simply get revealed. So you can only see where they are, but you can't do anything about that. So I think that Sumeru's damage is probably going to take yet another hit. I would not be surprised to see Mirror Images nerfed down to 20%. But I think really what the problem is going to be his ability to get away easy. Which, now, one thing I will say, because I'm not a Sumeru player, but I have been watching a lot of people who do play it. One thing I will say is that if Blizzard isn't careful, which is the reason why they worded it this way, they will make Sumeru unplayable. Because they can't really mess with his survivability, since it's all tied into his ability to simply just shed aggro, for those of you familiar with that term. Is there going to be an easy fix to Sumeru? No. I don't think that nerfing his damage is really the answer. What I would probably think about doing, and again, I'm not here to tell Blizzard what to do. I do think that Sumeru is going to need a little bit of... He's going to need some compensation. If they do end up taking a look at his ability to break CC and sort of shed that... And by the way, if I say CC, I mean crowd control, like stuns, roots, etc. If they do decide to tweak that, then he's going to need some sort of compensation to help out with his survivability, but not in a way that it's going to make him too tanky. So, again, I don't envy Blizzard at all for doing the game balance changes. I know how easy it is to you do one slight thing, it's going to completely break the game in some respects for certain heroes. But for those of you Sumeru players out there, I would say that don't be surprised if we see another round of nerfs to his damage. I actually would be surprised if we don't see that 25% go down to 20%. I'm not saying anytime soon, because there's going to be some time for them to parse the data after this change goes through today. But yeah, so we're still talking about Sumeru, even though he's been out for a couple weeks now. They're still adjusting him, and again, Heroes of the Storm and all online games are going to always be subject to change and improvements. So I applaud Blizzard for doing this. I think that hopefully they'll take a little bit of a harder look at it. It's not just the damage that people have a problem with Sumeru, but we'll see how it goes. So I don't want to get too ahead of myself. So again, that was just my prediction. Whether or not it comes true or not, who knows? Only Blizzard does, I guess. So, moving on to Murky. Murky is getting a little bit of help here, and not to take a too positive spin on what we were just talking about, with a little bit of negative connotation there with Sumeru, but Murky is possibly getting a rework soon. Oh yeah, Murky, his damage has been increased for the slime by 4 at a base value, so it's 82 to 86 now, which is pretty nice. And the pufferfish has been increased over 410 to be specific for Murky's W ability. Again, this is all the base damage, and that is huge, because you have to remember that Murky also, like some other assassins, even though he's a specialist, Murky also runs off of a scaled percentage value for most of his abilities. I mean, you can say that for pretty much like everybody, every hero, but more so for Murky just because of how powerful he actually is when he starts rolling along, especially if he takes Living the Dream, etc., etc. So, what Blizzard says is, I'm not even going to try to read that, I'm not even going to make an attempt because too many people would laugh at me. Translated, that means that he's getting a 5% buff to most of his damage, but we expect to see larger talent changes in the early part of next year. Did you hear that? I'm going to read that last little blurb again. But expect to see larger talent changes in the early part of next year. So, what this tells me is that sometime after the rollover to 2017, we are going to see a murky rework, or they're going to completely go down the line and try to streamline some of the talents to make them a little bit more enticing. I think that right now, murky has the problem that a lot of other heroes do that have been out for a long time, which is that there's just simply an optimal choice to pick for all talents, in my opinion anyway. So let me know how you feel about that down below. Like I said, it's I'm very excited as a murky player. It's so weird that I call myself that, as everyone who's ever watched me specifically for the past couple years, you know I used to hate murky, and now he's certainly one of my go-to specialists because I love him. But yeah, I am very excited to hear some murky changes, and I cannot wait to get into the live client and start doing it. Maybe we'll have another murky solo queue ceiling is coming soon. Now, on to a little bit of a downer here, as again, I am a Malfurion player as well. Malfurion is getting hit a little bit. The cooldown on Shando's Clarity has been reduced from 10 to 8 seconds. The cooldown reduction, I should say. But Moonburn, the bonus damage against non-heroes have been reduced to 100% to 75. So, basically, this was an issue with Malfurion because of the way the Moonfire works. It can hit literally an unlimited amount of targets, and Blizzard wanted to cut down Malfurion's laning ability, pretty much. And then Alun's Greats, which is his passive, the ability range has been decreased from 30% to 25%. It's not that significant of a nerf for the range, but it is still, it does warrant a little bit of worry for those of us who are Malfurion players, which again, I am, because I do usually take Alun's Greats, depending on the circumstances, but if you want to go the Entangling Roots build or something like that, you're going to have to be a little bit closer. So what Blizzard says, similar to ETC, let's talk about it in a moment, Malfurion is simply a little too powerful. We're toning down some of his talents to keep him more in line with other supports. I don't like these changes only because I really want them to bring back Conjurer's Pursuit. And I know that I've been on record for saying that over and over again with Malfurion. I still don't know to this day why they removed it for him. But in my opinion, I don't think Malfurion was ever really a problem as far as damage, overall damage output's concerned. Sure, he can do a lot of damage as a support, but there's a couple other supports out there, mainly the one that I can think of is Karazhan, that can deal more damage than they probably would be expected to do. So I don't think it's a problem that Malfurion can deal somewhat similar damage. It's not like he's blowing up the damage meters, and if he is, it wasn't going to be on hero damage. It's going to be on siege damage and laning and that sort of thing. So again, this is one of the few times where I'll say that I probably don't agree with the changes here for Malfurion, because he, in my opinion, he doesn't need help except in the mana regeneration like category. It's hard for me to say this because it makes it seem like I'm a little bit sad just because they're touching one of my favorite characters, and I don't mind that they're working on that, but I feel like the damage wasn't an issue, and certainly the range of Loon's Grace is also not an issue, in my opinion anyway, because there's so many ways for you to get out of range, and Entangling Roots especially is so telegraphed. So, but obviously they didn't change Loon's Grace just because of Entangling Roots. It's more so for the Moonfire than everything, so we'll see how it goes along. Am I happy with this change? No, not really, but that's how it goes sometimes. Sometimes you win, sometimes you lose. ETC. So, ETC, the base health has been reduced by a whole lot. His regen's also been reduced by a little bit. Progressive Rock now, that is going to be the talent at level 1. The quest reward healing allies has been reduced from 53 to 30. Not that big of a deal. Echo Petal. Now, this is the one that is a little bit more in line with what we just saw with Malfurion. The bonus damage to mercenaries and minions have been reduced from 100% to 75%. Now, Face Melt, and this is a talent that I do take sometimes here on his W ability. The slow amount has been reduced by 10%. Again, that was probably needed because it was kind of ridiculous that ETC had one of the most powerful, if not the most powerful slow in the game that he can rattle off without really having to worry about any repercussions. So Blizzard says ETC is a little too strong at all levels of play, so we're looking to trim down his power. He also has a few overperforming talents such as Progressive Rock, Echo Petal, and Face Melt, so we're lowering the power to make the other talents in the tier more competitive. I think this is the right move for ETC overall. He's just simply able to do everything. He can heal, he can tank, he can deal damage, he can do AoE, he can slow, he can stun, he can CC, blah, blah, blah. You see where I'm going with this. I do play ETC from time to time. He's not one of my favorite characters, but overall, this is going to hopefully lead to a little bit less frustration when you see an ETC on the other team. Now, Muradin getting a little bit of help, which, and this was a probably one of the biggest surprises of this change here for the patch today. His base health has been increased by that. It's it's pretty remarkable that they're even doing anything to Muradin's base health, because again, he, as a warrior, as especially as probably one of the tankiest warriors in the game, I was surprised to see that. I'm pretty sure a lot of people are going to see that as well. The health regen has also been increased, a little bit of surprise there considering that he has second wind. Talents, crowd control, this is basically going to be it's going to get an additional functionality. It also refunds 5 mana per enemy hit, meaning that you're able to use Thunderclap a lot more. Skullcracker, that's going to be the one that also gives you a chance to stun whenever you hit your basic attacks. I think it gets the second or third basic consecutive attack on the same target. Now, also passively increases Muradin's attack speed by 25%. 25%. Now, think about that. When you go over to heavy impact here, and again, I want to make sure that everyone is clear on this, that I'm surprised that they're doing anything about Muradin at all. But Iron Forge Momentum, this is basically battle momentum for Muradin. No longer decreases the cooldown of Dwarf Toss, and that is directly because of the stun duration nerf that they're doing there for level 16, which basically means that you're not going to be able to chain stun entire teams as Muradin. Let's put it that way. So what Blizzard says about that, so again, that's a little bit of a nerf there. But what Blizzard says is, Muradin's pick rate for both Hero League and Pro Play continues to be extremely high. Oddly enough, his win rate is actually below average in most levels of play. We realize that he brings a very versatile kit that allows him to be a great solo warrior for his team. Our main change to offset his health is to remove the escape effectiveness of Ironforge Momentum. And next week, we'll also be reducing the amount of health that Avatar provides. Again, you had to read the blurb here in order for you to not be surprised at this point, because they are going to address the Avatar concerns that you probably had at the beginning of the Muradin section. The rest of the changes are minimal and targeted towards talent win pick rate. So, yeah. So, again, that's what I was really surprised to see, anything and everything to do with Muradin's base health because of Avatar. But now that Blizzard has talked about it, we know that they are going to make sure that he's not he's not going to be like Diablo levels of HP. So moving on to Zarya, everybody's probably favorite Overwatch character in Heroes of the Storm. Tracer's still up there as well, but I think that Zarya has sort of been the darling pick, especially after the buffs that she received. She's getting nerfed again, so here we go on this one. Demolition Expert, that has been reduced now of hitting five heroes, increased to half of a point for those of you who do end up going Demolition's Expert, which I think most of people probably do. Together We Are Strong, increased energy dealt from per enemy. Let's try this again. Decreased energy per damage dealt from 10 to 9, and then increased the maximum energy gained from 25 to 30. So they're adjusting a couple things here back and forth with Zarya. Sometimes it's an overtune, sometimes it's an overtune, sometimes it's an undertune, sometimes it's an overtune. For Zarya, it's a little bit of a mixed bag here, because they want to make sure that they're not making her too strong, but I don't want to get it myself on this one. Maximum charge is going to be the trait. The quest completion time is increased from 120 to 150. That's where the seconds is concerned on that one. The block charge duration has been reduced by half. That is huge. That is a big hit to Zarya's survivability if you take defensive shielding, which is going to... It's basically going to cut everything in half as far as the duration it goes for the block charges that you get. And I realize that's what I just read, but you have to keep in mind, that's a long, long time to go from, well, I have block charges, I can run in and engage, versus now, which used to be, you had a 12-second leeway of actually getting those block charges to be useful. To now, it's like, well, I hope that you're inside of some sort of a huge team fight, because otherwise you're not going to have any benefit at all from taking defensive shielding. The bonus energy from Zarya's shields have been decreased from 15%. Again, Blizzard's addressing the energy gains that Zarya can produce for herself by just sort of jumping into the fray. Unstoppable Competitor has been increased a little bit. That's just going to be a little bit, again, sort of the back and forth seesaw that they're doing here with Zarya. Same thing goes for Endurance Training, it goes the opposite way. And then a couple other changes there. Specifically speaking to the Cleansing Shield, also decreases the cooldown of Shield Ally from 12 seconds to 10 seconds. That's a level 16 ability, which is actually kind of a nice thing, that it's only going to be that her E ability, the particle shield, is only going to be on a shield ally. It's 10 seconds. That's like nothing in a team fight. That's going to be huge for Zarya. Expect to see Cleansing Shield picked a whole lot more so than it already is. Most people also went the Plasma Shock range of being like a crowd control Zarya, but I have a feeling that Cleansing Shield is going to entice people to go that way instead of going for the slow on Zarya. Again, just a hunch. So what Blizzard says Oh yeah, and the active ability here for her Storm Talent has been increased by 15%. That's the cooldown, so again, kind of a nerf there. What Blizzard says is Zarya's power level is slightly higher than we'd like, than what we'd like, and in general, her energy challenge is stronger than all other options on her on their tiers. These changes should increase the talent diversity and deliver a slight nerf on the hero. So again, it's back and forth. I'd say it's a little bit more significant than just a slight nerf, but there you go. So are you a Zarya player? Are you happy about this? Are you a Vala player? Are you upset? Are you a Murky player who's excited? Are you a Samura player who absolutely hates or loves the changes? Let me know in the comments down below. I'm going to wrap up this video. Thank you for watching, everyone. Big thumbs up for Blizzard for keeping us all informed as well as adjusting their game for the better. I really do. I love playing it, and especially with all the new stuff that we got coming out soon. Expect to see more Heroes of the content here on the channel as well. So thank you for watching. Hope you had a fantastic day, and of course, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody!